Hello and welcome to biology class. We are studying topic kingdom Animalia, and so far we reached till phylum Chordata, and now we are studying detailed classification of phylum Chordata. So phylum Chordata is further divided into subphylums, three subphylums. We studied all the three subphylums, and finally we reached to the subphylum Vertebrata. So subphylum Vertebrata is further divided into divisions. We studied those divisions. Which are those divisions? Gnathostomata and Agnathostomata. Then we studied Agnathostomata, its classification, like Cyclostomata is only one class included in that. Then we started studying classification of Gnathostomata, and Gnathostomata is further divided into two superclasses, Pisces and Tetrapoda. So these two superclasses, we started studying first superclass among them, which is nothing but Pisces. And Pisces is including two classes. One is Chondrioptis. We already studied about the Chondrioptis, and today we will study the second class in the superclass Pisces, that is Osteoptis. So let us begin with the study of Osteoptis. So Osteoptis, obviously it is a class of superclass Pisces, means it will also include fish. Now this is a typical diagram of a fish in the Osteoptis. So by considering this typical picture of fish, let us try to understand characteristics of Osteoptis. Now when we consider Osteoptis, osteo, this word means bones. What do you mean by osteo? Osteo means bones. Even our bones are also called as osteo. Now, and ithis, this word represent fish. What do you mean by ithis? It is nothing but fish. Okay. Now, so the fish with bones is nothing but bony fish. Okay. So all bony fish are included into the class Osteoptis. Now, when I consider this bony fish, obviously when I talk about bony fish simply means endoskeleton is made up of bones. Endoskeleton, bones. Understanding? So the first characteristic of this Osteoptis is these are fish, as they are included in Pisces, and endoskeleton of this fish are made up of bones particularly. Clear about it? So this is the first characteristic. So let us go ahead and try to understand some more characteristics. Now see, when this is a typical diagram of one fish in the Osteoptis. Now by looking at the diagram, let us try to understand the characteristics. Now when we see fish, the main characteristic of fish is nothing but presence of fins. Okay, so here what different type of fins we can see, that we will try to understand. Now here whatever fin we see near the head, this is nothing but pectoral fin. Okay, and pectoral fin are paired, means one more fin is on the another side of fish. This is on the left side, another will be on the right side. Okay, so this is a pair of pectoral fin. Then there is a pair of pelvic fin. Here the pelvic fin is located. Okay, here in case of bony fish, the pelvic fin is not near the tail region, it is also somewhat near to head region. Okay, so a paired fins, pectoral fin is one and pelvic fin is another one. Understanding? So let us try to understand what other fins are present. Now another large fin which is present at the tail region, it is called as caudal fin. Understanding? Then it is unpaired, only single caudal fin is there. Then there are dorsal fins. There are here we can see two dorsal fins. This is one and this is another. And there is even a ventral fin. Here anal fin, can you see anal fin? This anal fin is nothing but on the ventral side of the body. See, I am repeating, how many fins are there? One pair of pectoral fin. One pair of pelvic fin. Pair means they are on the left and as well as on the right side. Then a single ventral fin. Single ventral fin. Here whatever name anal fin is given, it is nothing but ventral fin, because it is located on the ventral side. Then two dorsal fins, understanding? And one caudal fin. So these are the different type and different number of fins present in the osteoctys, fins present in the. One more thing you need to understand about fins is that here you can see these spiny structures in the fins. Agree? There is a spiny structure in the dorsal fin, as well as you can see there is a spiny structure in ventral fin. Now these spiny structures are called as fin rays. What does they are called as? Fin rays. Now when I consider these fin rays are the supporting structure which support fins. Understanding? This kind of fin rays are not observed in the chondrioctys. It is a special characteristic of osteoctys. Now these fin rays support the fin properly, and they either made up of cartilage or sometime bones. It depend on what structure they are made up of. They depend on which type of fish it is. Okay. So fins are supported by fin rays. So about the fin is the second characteristic. First characteristic is about its endoskeleton, why it is called as osteoctys, and second characteristic is about its fins. So different type of fins you need to write, and you need to write about fin rays. Now let us shift to the third characteristic of bony fish. Now when I consider the shape of the fish, okay, you can always observe the shape is streamline or boat shaped. Okay, it is tapering on the both side and swollen on the middle side. Okay, so this shape, this particular shape of the bony fish help it to swim properly, help it to minimize the resistance while swimming. Okay, so this shape is important. So third characteristic is about its shape. The fourth characteristic, let us talk about its digestive system. Now digestive system consists of mouth, okay, and mouth is terminal mouth, means always at the one end of the fish, okay, and alimentary canal, that is digestive system end or open as a anus. Remember, in the chondrioctys it was opening as a cloacal aperture, but in the bony fish it is opening as the anus. Remember this, when cloacal aperture and when anus. Okay, so this is the fourth characteristic. When we talk about the exoskeleton of the bony fish, it is made up of scales. The exoskeleton of the bony fish is always made up of scales. But those scales are different than osteoctys. The scale in the bony fish are made up of tenoid scales, either tenoid scales or glenoid scales or cycloid scales, either one of them. Okay, now cycloid is the most common, even tenoid are common in many bony fish, and the shape of the scale is something like this. They are tapering at one end and they are having something like this design on the another side. Okay, and they are usually larger as compared to the placoid scales which are observed in the chondrioctys. So scales are little bit bigger in size and they are more protective in function. Understanding? So this is the fourth characteristic. Now next characteristic of a bony fish is about its respiration. Now respiration is branchial respiration. Branchial respiration means respiration with the help of gills. Okay, but here the gill slits are present inside this flap. Can you see this flap, which is called as operculum? Okay, so operculum is the covering on the gills. Okay, and inside this covering there are gills, and there are always four pairs of gills. How many gills? Four pairs. Four on this side and four on another side. Understanding? So four pairs of gills, and respiration is branchial respiration, and these gills are always covered by operculum. Now one more thing you need to remember. Now these fish are provided with swim bladder. Okay, swim bladder or air bladder. It is a bag like structure which is present inside the stomach over here. Okay, and in this bag fish basically store air in this bladder, and when it store air, the stored air help the fish to to float in the water. It do not allow fish to sink. So without swimming activity also fish can float on water. Understanding? That cannot be done by the shark or other contrarious fish. Understanding? Now next thing, so this will also come under respiration. Now next thing is about circulatory system of fish. Now circulatory system is closed type of circulatory system, that is obvious because all vertebrate are having closed type of circulatory system. Two chambered heart it show. Okay, just like chondrioctis, it also show two chambered heart. Sinus venosus and conus arteriosus are the two chambers. You need to remember these names. Okay, by heart them properly. Two chamber, sinus venosus, conus arteriosus. Now next thing you need to remember is about they are having biconcave RBCs, and RBCs are red because they contain hemoglobin. Next characteristic you need to remember about the bony fish is about its reproduction. Okay, now when we consider reproduction in the bony fish, reproduction is basically it is a unisexual, means male and female, two different animals are there, two different fish are there, but generally they don't show sexual dimorphism, means externally we cannot recognize this is the male and this is the female. Okay, most of the time fertilization is external fertilization, means female lay egg in water and male go and fertilize those eggs with the help of sperm. Okay, and development is also sometime direct, sometime indirect. So it depends on the type of fish, but generally fertilization is external and development is sometime direct, sometime indirect. Okay, now one more thing you need to remember about bony fish is that they are amniotelic animals. Means amniotelic means they excrete ammonia as a waste product. Okay, and ammonia is generally excreted through skin. Understanding? So these are the some important characteristics of osteoctis. So let us see some pictures of exceptional fishes, some different fish and different type of bony fish, and then we'll enlist all the characteristics which we have studied just now. Now let us try to understand some different type of fish and their different modifications in the bony fish, and then we'll enlist all the characteristics of bony fish. So the first exceptional or different type of bony fish is this. It is a fish named as the Exocoetus. Now Exocoetus is kind of not a common name. Commonly it is known as a flying fish. Now this fish actually do not fly as such, but it jump in water at like a long distance. Rather than swimming, it prefer jumping in water, and these kind of fins, help him to jump in water, and it takes such a long jump that it appear like it is a fly. This fish is flying in a water, okay, flying over the water. So these are called as a flying fish. In the Bay of Bengal, this fish is commonly found. Okay. Now next different type of fish. This fish is called as eel. Okay. It is appear more like a snake rather than fish. Okay. But it is try to understand. It is a fish, not a snake. This is another fish called as Bombay duck. Now what is the speciality of Bombay duck? Now Bombay duck is typically meant for carnivores or meant for capturing the prey. Its jaw is really larger. It can open its jaw twice or thrice the size of its original, and it can capture a larger prey rather than any other fish. And this is a very beautiful fish called as a seahorse. Now this fish is basically observed in the coral region, okay, and it stay in the coral and it totally match in the coral. Now this fish is rather than fish, it look like horse, okay, and a very beautiful fish. So these are some exceptional fish, and let us go and enlist the characteristics of bony fish. So osteoctis, nothing but the bony fish. The first characteristic is osteon means bone and itis means fish, that's why they are called as bony fish. Then always aquatic, marine in habitat, mostly marine but even fresh water, and some of them even can stay in mud. For example, lungfish, it can stay in mud. okay. Then skeleton, exoskeleton is bony and endoskeleton made up of either cycloid scale, glenoid or tenoid scales. We just studied them. Then next one is fin. Paired fins are pelvic and pectoral. Unpaired are dorsal, ventral and caudal fins. Fins show the presence of fin rays. Then next one is digestive system. Mouth is always terminal and alimentary canal open as a anus. Next characteristic is about its respiratory system. Always branchial respiration, respiration with the help of gills. Okay. Gill cover is there called as operculum. Understanding? Swim bladder is present and swim bladder, because of swim bladder, it can float in water easily rather than, means it need not to spend its energy every time for swimming. Then circulatory system, when we consider, there is a two-chambered heart, sinus venosus and conus arteriosus are the two chambers, and nucleated and biconcave RBCs. Then nervous system, I forgot to tell you about nervous system. Now remember, when we consider nervous system of this fish, there are 10 cranial nerves. I taught you what are cranial nerves. Do you remember them? Cranial nerves are the nerves which start from the brain. Okay, so the nerves which come out from the brain are called as cranial nerves. And cerebellum means a part of brain, as well as olfactory lobes, which is responsible for smelling ability, are not much developed as a chondrioctes. In chondrioctes, they are very well developed. So next characteristic is about excretory system. Amenotelic animals, kidneys work as an excretory organ, and excretion is done by the skin. Then they are cold-blooded animal. One more characteristic, spindle-shaped body. Then reproduction, many a times unisexual, do not show sexual dimorphism, but some fish like seahorse show sexual dimorphism. Fertilization may be external or internal, and development is may be direct or indirect. There are around 25,000 or more species of fish we know, and some examples are seahorse, katla, eel, catfish and many others. So this is all about bony fish. Try to remember all the characteristics of bony fish, and more specifically remember about their fins. Okay. So in the next video, we will study tetrapoda, and till then, take care. Goodbye.